Triple H. Oh, Skewo. Oh, here we go. Streaming now. There we go. Gotta watch this stupid fucking ad on my 4K TV. Yeah. I'm a damn commentator.
Yeah, well, guess what? Fire Pro can only go 1080, so.
Yeah.
Well, it can go 4K, but you won't ever notice it.
True. That's actually for true right there. But yeah, welcome to the GRFC to the Death post show. Tuesday show. Ooh. you know what? I said this when we went off the air, you know, after I said cut us off, and you were like, what? when I finally got Gargura to say, ah, as the send-off.
Yeah, it took fucking forever.
Yeah, well, the problem was I skipped ahead of it by accident, because it was a 45-second clip, and, like, 43 seconds of it is just silence. But yeah, so I said after the show, I was like, damn, this might have been one of the best fucking shows that we've done. Honestly, and like when we do the end of the year awards, this is definitely going to be like in the pay-per-views to vote for. The only other one I could think of where top to bottom, it was a really amazing show, was GRFC Lockdown, like as far as like the Tuesday side goes.
Homecoming, like, averaged like an 88 between two brands when we did the cross brand thing.
Yeah, because that was one of the cross brand ones. Because I screenshotted the match card, and this is just insane. Like, just real quick before we start the matches, I'm just gonna like briefly just go over the matches that we had this pay per view, because this is when we only had like five each. We had Stitch and Mortius taking on Craig Copeland and Mario Colone, who were the tag champs at the time, in a tornado tag barbed wire death match for the Tuesday tag titles.
After that, I remember didn't get a high rating.
Yeah, we followed that up with Hollywood Hannah versus Yukina in Extreme Rules Texas death match. That one was nuts. Tony the Milkman versus Praise. And a gruesome rules mid-card title match. The Praise was the champ. That was with that whole storyline. The co-main event was George versus Zack Roper versus Mar Rivers in a triple threat steel cage match, elimination style, for the top tier heavyweight championship. This is when Mar Rivers was the champ, and we followed it up with the main event. Yeah, first one. That, like, Zach beat him that night. Spoilers. I mean, do I really need to say that at this point? Hell's Harlots. The main event was Hell's Harlots and Carmella Noctum versus Babe Ruthless, God Goddesses, and Violet Jet, where for the first time ever, this is the first ever War Games match, and to add on to that, Babe Ruth has put her title on the line in that match. That was nuts. So, that's the only other match card where I was like, just top and bottom, I was like, this is a fucking kick-ass pay-per-view.
Yeah, you defend the title and tag team as a main event. We get some crazy bullshit for matches.
Yeah. I mean, last night was just full of shocks, surprises, heartwarming moments. Commando Shark in the main event, winning it for all the shrimps and his idol Gargura. And then that asshole Edgar Rossi had to come out and ruin his party. That son of a bitch. So it's 7:47. The bot said we're live. I'm just gonna post at everyone we're live just to double it.
Okay.
We're live!
Ah! Is anyone seeing it? Who knows? Probably not.
Who knows? Who knows?
We got 131 people on the server and none of y'all ever talk.
Watch this! But yeah, so... Yeah, definitely the end of the year poll and results. I feel like we should, like, do the results live as a stream, just cause. Yeah. Just do a fucking Slammy Award for it.
Yeah, just have except, both friends, you know, on at the same time.
Yeah, but, you know, instead of, like, the Slammiest words, like, predetermined winners, like, it's the winners that are actually voted by people.
Yeah.
So. It's like, Neville won Superstar, or, what was it, like, Breakout Star of the Year, and Kevin Owens didn't win it. I was like, this is definitely some bullshit. Because Kevin Owens had just come after, like, beating Cena, like, clean. I was like, yeah, this is fucking bullshit. But yeah, enough about that. The Proving Grounds tournament continues. I have no fucking idea if we're going to even end this by the end of the year. This might carry on for the new year.
So.
Yeah, no, there's no fucking way.
It will end in February.
Probably. Fuck yeah. I mean, hell yeah. So these matches could potentially have a Breakout Star of the Year award. So, yeah, speaking of which, Kenny Bowers versus Giants Balls. Giants Balls just coming straight out of defending his title. Like, it's Tomahawk, who was trying to win the title for his village, but he failed.
He kind of always fails in the big picture.
Yeah. Well, you know what? Giants Ball shouldn't be too comfortable because he's got Motionless One next. And if Kenny Bowers beats him, he's got to have. And if enough people beat him before the pay-per-view, it's just going to be like, all right, multi-man match. Good luck, pal. As you can tell, I'm hyped up from this monster.
He just slammed down a bunch of it and took some stackers. You're good to go.
If you, like, the more hyper I am, the more you can tell the less sleep I've had.
Is that really the way it's all?
Yeah, because, like, I'm more hyper when I'm tired. It's weird.
That sounds like a bad thing to have.
Yeah, well. I don't fuck. Alright, Kenny Bowers. If I look at his standings, let's see. Kenny Bowers has 0 points. He's hoping to turn it around against Giants Ball, who also has 0 points. He may have 0 points, but he's sponsored by Nike, and he's filming Space Jam 2.
I mean, he's got money, and somehow has a title, so I guess.
Yeah.
Cool stuff.
You know what? That title match could be the push he needs.
What? I mean, what push does he need? He's already a deathmatch champ. He's just... doesn't seem to win any matches besides when they count.
Right, exactly. Alright. So, who you got in this match? I'm not gonna even ask the chat because there's like no one in here.
Rip. Why is there? What's your product, damn it? 130 people for what?
Right. Fuck, hey, babe. I'm gonna tell it the way it is.
Right.
Honestly?
Oh, phew.
I got Kenny Bowers.
Right, as, he gets... as he gets swung around like a chest.
Yeah, as he gets spun around like a fucking Beyblade. Let's Beyblade! Let it rain! Fuck, that song rules.
That show did not last long.
It didn't.
What is it, like two seasons?
Yeah, they made an anime of it, and that didn't... Like, I remember actually watching it, like, yes. Before I went to school. Like, I went over to, like... I had a friend where we all just kind of hung out before we went to school, and I was playing. And I was like, damn, this is kind of neat.
I don't even know if they still make this shit.
I mean, they might. I'm not sure. Hold on, I can look up how many seasons of Beyblade they had. Hold on.
No, I'm talking about the toys, though. Like, I don't even know if to make those anymore.
Yeah. They might, actually. What's the Beyblade episodes from Wikipedia? So, you know, gotta be careful about that. 12 episodes for the main series overview.
That's it? Oh my god. You got
Beyblade, Beyblade Metal Fusion, and Beyblade Burst.
Wow, so basically put like 30 episodes?
Maybe.
That's. Huh. That did not last long at all. 5 minutes gone. It's not done that well.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, they still sell them. I just don't know if they make any new ones.
Speaking of old, like, trading card and other bullshit-type accessories made into an anime, what about the Byakugan?
What was that one where it was, like, a ball, and then when it, like, went on the card or whatever, it, like, turned into something?
That's why I just literally said Byakugan. Oh, wow.
6 minutes! 6 minutes flat! Kenny Powers can't catch a break.
You blinked your eyes and that one ended just 56.
56. Saboteur, I say. Saboteur.
I mean, they
Jesus only, Christ.
They only lasted 6 minutes.
Damn, Giant's ball is feeling primal. He's feeling different after that peer review.
They lasted about as long as Selena and Bieber.
Ah. Alright, well, 2 points finally for Giant's ball.
Took them
and now we move on to the B block, where Sayoko and Wallspur both have 0 points. So it's kind of the same thing that we did in the last match.
Yeah, they're kind of just scrubbing it on out.
Right.
I thought Giant's ball had 4 points, though. I thought Kenny has 2.
No, Kenny has 0.
He has 0. If I remember
correctly. Damn, now I'm going to have to look this up.
Because if I had Giant's ball one, he's 1.
No, Giant's ball defended his title. Yeah. That wasn't a block. That wasn't a block match.
Well, he's a big old piece of trash. Then.
Yeah, he lost to Tomahawk, and he lost the motionless one. Yeah, and then Elva Kanto defeated Kenny Bowers last on the mat night 2. Let's see. Night 1.
When I hear the trumpet sound,
yeah, Shooter Man defeated Kenny Barrett. So yeah, see? You try to question my integrity. Alright. Commentator's curse, but I'm going with Wildspur.
Yeah, I mean, he's good. Ain't no grave, so he's undefeatable now.
Ain't no grave, can you hold my body down? Is that the Undertaker? I remember he came out to that, and then it was like, dun-dun! Triple H fucking came out to set up that match.
I didn't know Luke Harper used Undertaker's theme.
Oh god, he does look like Luke Harper. What the fuck? Oh, I mean, hold on. Don't you mean Mr. Brody Lee?
Yeah, I made the guy that inadvertently kind of looks like Harper, so.
Yeah.
And then you gave him a ticker theme to the Cowboys from Hell, so.
Yeah. Yeah, because, like, I was like, hell yeah, this dude's gonna rock fucking Johnny Cash. It was either that or it was gonna be Hurt, but then I'm like, nah, the fucking Nine Inch Nails one is better.
Yeah, it really is.
Duh. Like, the only reason that people don't diss Hurt by Johnny Cash is because that was literally his last song.
Yeah.
But if it wasn't his last song, people would be like, fuck that, Nine Inch Nails is better.
Yeah, it wasn't bad, but I mean, Nine Inch Nails is definitely the better one.
Yeah. I mean, the Johnny Cash one was good enough to be used in the Logan trailer, so...
Yeah.
You got that. I mean, that song actually fucking suits Logan. It's just, like, the most, like, depressing, fucking sad, and, like, dirty song that they could have used. Like, gritty, I guess, not dirty. Same diff.
Gritty, dirty, muddy.
Dude, I knew, like, immediately in the theater when Wolverine had, like, the claws out and he sliced that one dude's arm off, I'm like, oh, fuck, here we go. This is what I've been waiting for.
Yeah, Reign and Wolverine movie, like, took them long enough.
Yeah. Because they almost made the Wolverine, the one where he goes to Japan, rated R. Like, there's, if you actually get the unrated cut... That was the one that they almost had in theaters, but at the last minute, they're like, nah, let's save it for something else. And, yeah, Logan was the one they did. I mean, Hugh Jackman even just went out and he was like, yeah, fuck it, I'm not gonna... Because normally actors will, like, you know, get paid, like, a full salary or whatever. He was like... Hugh Jackman was like, I'll take a fucking pay cut to make it rated R if that's what it takes. And the studio's like, alright, well, you can. I guess you can make a rated R then.
Damn,
yeah, for whatever weird reason, like, I've looked this up, for whatever weird reason, studios just aren't comfortable with, like, rated R movies because they feel like it doesn't, like, bring in that much money.
I mean, technically, you don't bring kids rated R movies, so, I mean, in that aspect, they're right.
But unless you're a fucking weirdo. I remember I was 12 years old. I don't remember what movie I was seeing, but Rob Zombie's Halloween just came out. And I remember we were, like, going to order the ticket for whatever movie we were seeing, and this dad had brought his kid, and he was like, one ticket for Halloween. And I'm like, wait, are you, like, for real? Or, no, two...
You're gonna traumatize, like, your kid.
Two tickets for Halloween. It's like, damn, fuck, okay. Damn, what the fuck? He landed him so hard, his fucking head bounced off the canvas.
The bowl hammer didn't get it done.
Nah, he's gonna do the discus lariat. Put some oomph into it.
Yeah, he's gonna do the cell where he turns inside out and flips upside down.
Oh yeah, do the flip bump. I mean, maybe I haven't been paying attention to the match that much, but I feel like this has been all wild spurs so far.
Oh no, it definitely has.
Like, Psycho's getting, like, a couple licks in, but this has mostly just been a wild spur match.
I mean, Psycho has a stamina, maybe if he outlasts the Onslaught.
Maybe. But as soon as he goes to the outside, that's pretty much over. At this point, Wattsburg is just beating the shit out of him.
Yeah, this is just a mugging right now.
Like, this feels honestly like a New Japan match right here. Like, oh man, it'd be so sick if Fire Pro, like, added, like, the sweat effects. Where, like, if you get, like, slapped in the face or something, like, the sweat fucking comes off.
Oh, I was gonna say, because, like, the mod did add sweat to them. Like, that's why they get shiny and shit, but yeah, like that.
Right. Yeah, like the fucking Minoru Suzuki slaps fucking, like, sweat comes on. Nah, I don't know. He's got it set in the corner. Like, go stay down. Oh, God.
Count to 1,000.
And with authority, Wild Spur gets 2 points.
Back to back matches with just absolute muggings.
Holy Christ. The Bastard Blaster. That's true. 68?
I mean...
Damn.
It was pretty one-sided.
It was pretty one-sided, you're right. Hopefully these next matches kind of bring up the ratings.
I mean...
It's not about ratings, guys.
Yeah, I was gonna say, y'all... You and Monday kind of don't even pay attention to ratings anymore, so it's whatever.
Yeah. All good. Yeah,
do your best.
Don't be a mark.
Who cares about ratings?
Alright. This one should be interesting. Because this is the goddesses taking on Mortal Kombat to advance to the... Yeah.
How the fuck did you manage that?
I don't... whoever, as I was saying, the team... Whoever wins is advancing to the finals. That the finals are gonna be next week. It's gonna be amazing. Yeah. Next week we might scale it back to 10 matches since, we're only gonna have one. I can probably keep it. I don't know. I'll think about it.
I mean, the tournament thing's not going on anymore, so... The finals end.
Yeah. You know what? I've told the story already. I'm not gonna say it every time.
Why not? Talking about the themes of replaying?
No, about me getting in a fight with my friend for in Baby Metal.
Yeah.
I've already told that story at this point. It'd be redundant to keep bringing it up. I gotta say, this theme fucking rules. For Jade.
He's going all the Mortal Kombat names there.
I mean, look, it was a joke, but it's actually pretty accurate with how they've been winning their matches. Really, all right, chat. There's one more person in here. I'm gonna ask you too, Dobby, whatever your name is. You guys have advancing to the finals. Mortal Kombat or God Goddesses?
Scarlet and Jade.
Yeah. I mean, hey, maybe this might motivate them to actually win, but I got Mortal Kombat. They've been on a run. If you have a match with Hell's Harlots where it takes 20 minutes and they get a one count, that's a pretty tough team to beat. Honestly, a lot of people are saying that Mortal Kombat is going to be running away with the titles, but honestly, I stand by, unless the other team wins, I stand by my prediction that I made on the pay-per-view with who I think is winning the tournament. So we will wait and see that one on match 8.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like it heavily depends on what happens in that match, where Mortal Kombat has a better chance or not.
Yeah. Oh, hold on. Athena dodging that. Damn. Tagging Jade.
And Athena's kind of cleaning some house.
Yeah, I thought she missed for a second there.
I think she did.
Maybe.
Missing every strike in the world, why not?
Don't even walk out, ooh. I was like, damn, what is Athena have set up in the corner? Nothing, apparently. Off the ropes. Oh, dang. She was like, man, get that out of here. Ground bounce style. That's what we're known for. 5 minutes gone. So, yeah. The Proving Grounds tournaments have a 30-minute time limit. These don't. These are pretty much as long as it goes to get a winner.
Yeah, which sometimes can be quite a while.
Yeah, just like our main event at the pay-per-view. We're running out of time. Mr. Pats took liberties. He's like, fuck this, we're going home.
Yeah, because I had put the timer up, but the game said no,
No, no, no.
60 minutes ain't up for this Atlantis match.
Oh, hell yeah, Atlantis rules match. I'm done to see. Ain't no time left into the sea. 20,000 leagues out of the sea.
That'd be amazing if someone made a texture pack where the arena is just like completely blue, like water and shit, and then you do the thing to make it so there's no fans in the arena and it actually looks like an undersea fight.
Put shrimp. Put shrimp and other sea creatures in there.
Right? Just like gimmick of a match as much possible, right quick.
Oh, hell yeah. Every fucking zig.
Like, you have to use GIMP to use that type of shit. Which I don't really know how to use that. So.
Dang, well. She's just slapping the hell out of the back of her head. I mean, some people. I mean, some wrestlers either treat that as a wake up call or a sign of disrespect.
Supposed to be wake up call, but she kind of getting her ass whooped.
Wake up, smell of coffee. The greatest theme of all time.
Yeah. I don't even know why anybody would change away from that theme.
Right.
Except everyone. Speaking of,
speaking of people changing their themes, he's not. He's on. Oh well, hold on. Look at carrying the choke slam.
Someone should have checked, so.
That, I was gonna say, you're not gonna bring it up? I mean, you're that close to your partner? But yeah, she must have been confident. She was like, yeah, she ain't gonna work.
Oh, that's definitely scarred. She even get the little, scar and shit.
Right. You wanna know how I got these scars? Oh, Cymox Lamb! Big tribute to the big man, the big red machine, Kane! I don't know why, I was a dumb kid, but when I played Shut Your Mouth, and the announcer said the big red machine, I, for whatever reason, thought he said the big red monkey. The big red monkey, Kane! Oh, fuck! There's a device!
On the
non-legal person.
Come on, pulling our Doomsday device out of you.
Nah, do what Suki Samurai's did in the fucking Indie Killer. That was fucking sick.
Indie Killer.
Gotta fucking pop for that move.
Did the Indie Killer into the Twist Cutter, like, yeah, I don't think anyone's getting up after that.
Yeah, no, the finish was fucking sick. It was the, I forgot what the first move was, but, Sunrise ended it with the Stylus Clash. I'm like, oh, this is fucking hot. If you don't like that, then you're a virgin.
I figured that, I believe it was the spike pile driver into, like, a twist cutter and then just the fucking Styles Clash finally end it.
Probably.
They're doing a lot of shit though.
Yeah. They work really well as a team actually. Like that might be a permanent thing at this point, especially if they win the titles.
Yeah.
Like at that point it's gotta be burned. Unless, you know, cause I mean Nocturnal Samurai still hasn't, like, sworn allegiance to Hell Harlots, but if she does, they could technically, like, decide to Freebird rule it. Oh, holy fuck!
Assisted. Right.
Assisted. This is Lyriant. God, I fucking ruled. Holy fuck.
I didn't see a foot bump, though, so... Yeah, dude, flip bumps, you gotta take every bump.
Nah, you take it like you do. You take it as it is, kid. Dang, Goth Goddess is with the frequent tags.
Not really doing much, though.
There we go.
Damn, what are them?
Sidewalk Slam!
Hardly anyone does that move anymore. What a fucking shame. I don't think I've really seen it since Kane.
No.
I think I mean, Baron Corbin did it like once or twice at one point, yeah. But like, other than him, I don't think I've seen it.
He's more of a. He said he's more of a. Oh, fuck!
Please pet it like that. She's dead. What?
He said he's more of a big boss man kind of guy. Like, that's where he like gets a lot of his like moves from.
Yeah. Well, but, I don't think, yeah. Big Boss Man's doing a deep six anytime soon.
You're right. Well, I mean, you see, that's who his inspiration was, because he was a big guy that can move. Choke slam! But Scarlett's in.
Big guy that can move? I would have thought of Bam Bam Bigelow.
Oh, maybe that's who he was talking about.
Yeah, probably. Because I feel like
that's a rope break rev. The only people I've seen that do really good. Oh fuck, this is gonna end her career. The only people that have done sidewalk slams that I've liked are Kane and Kevin Nash.
Yeah.
Like, pretty much like big, lanky guys. Oh fuck, here we go. Doozy device.
Because Kevin Nash, isn't his the one where he like swings it a little bit and kicks out his leg at the very end of it?
Yeah, I think so.
Because I know one of them does it and it's pretty sweet. Like they
I
do
think that's Kane,
swing.
Actually. I think it's Kane that does that, actually.
What, the swing and kick out type deal?
Yeah.
Because that one's pretty sweet.
Like, because Kane will fucking get some height in his sidewalk slams. Then I also like the one where he, like, when someone's, like, running at him and he just fucking counters it by, like, doing, like, a little spin with it.
Yeah.
And then he, like, hits it. I'm like, damn, that fucking rules. God, oh man, the fact that none of the 2K games have added that animation is scuffed. Oh! Well, hold on, she didn't get to her in time.
I guess not, I mean, shit, he's kind of just standing there.
Damn, we might have to... frame by frame. We might have frame by frame, see if that actually... if there's any controversy.
Nah, nothing's controversial. Either
way, Mortal Kombat is in the finals. So they'll be waiting to see who their opponents are. Will it be Bad Omen, which is the team of Carmella and Mr. Charm, or will it be Suki Sunrise? We'll find out in match 8. We'll find out later tonight!
Huh?
I say, we'll find out later tonight! Oh, hell yeah. This piece of shit. Aya Rossi raining on his party. Alright, so... I got it right here. So
he needs to lose five so he can qualify for the fucking title.
This was the Top Tier Tuesday YouTube exclusive clip right here. Edgar Rossi clapped disingenuously as he watches Commander Shark celebrate winning the Cruiserweight Championship in the ring from the ramp area. Wow, whoopee. Good job, pal. Fucking act like you've been here before, you aquatic freak. The crowd boos. Hey, you think I give a single fuck about you people booing me? What do you call him, freak? Shrimp? Yeah, you'll go to hell. I tell you what, this Tuesday, I'm gonna knock you down a peg and beat you, and after that, I will earn the next shot at the title. Because that transition champ, George, can sit his ass at home and wait his turn. He drops the mic and finishes by flicking off the crowd with his chin. This piece of shit. Come on, Commander Shark. You gotta teach him who's boss. Because there's no way.
He will. He just had a 90-minute Texas death match. Yeah.
There's no way that this vulture can pick you off like this.
I
don't even think Edgar Rossi qualifies as a cruiserweight.
No, he needs to lose five to even get into the maximum limit.
At this point, he's just a bully.
Pretty much.
Gargura doesn't appreciate bullies.
Hey, that scrub of theirs in the front can qualify for Commander Shark style, though.
Yeah, here comes the United World team that said they were main eventers if they lost 4-on-2 handicap. Oh, Joe! Yes! Machine. He's here. He's feeling it. Now, quick statistic. Last time these two were in a ring together, Edgar Rossi's team lost to Miami Viceroy. But I mean, at that time, Edgar Rossi was teaming with the Italian Stallions. He said, they're a bunch of bums.
Yeah, they kind of were. But his new team's kind of terrible too, so I mean.
Look at these bums. Look at the dress. In my country, they say, if it cooks like a chicken, it's a chicken.
I mean, at least for Rossi, he's got some momentum on his side. He's won a few, right?
Well, you know what?
He says Gargura. He's undefeated, so I mean, he's definitely won a lot in a row in that case.
Gargura is transferring her spirit to Commander Shark. Not the shrimp out here, lend your energy! And hold on, Agatha Rossi reversing the power game. Yeah, this is what you call the feeling out process.
Failing out, you just drop kicked him in his face.
Yeah, well.
This guy's ready to go.
Okay, baby!
Sure.
Yeah, well. You bet. Hey, Shatui, or whatever that's called. Shouten, something like that. Ooh!
Form in the corner. The palm uppercut.
Oh. What's the spin kick called, then?
I forgot what the fuck it was. Shouten's the uppercut, though.
Okay, because I remember...
palm uppercut.
I remember they had it, like, something like that in the 2K games.
Yeah.
Hold on.
Japanese, so,
Yeah.
where Brainbuster is a suplex and a suplex is a Brainbuster. Oh.
Commander Shark, heavy Adonal stretch on Aguirre Rossi.
And a rope road. DDT is a Green Killer, which, I mean, yeah, I guess it's aptly named at that point. Yeah. Career's kind of ended.
Well, I mean, yeah, the Tokyo Pimp calls it that, so.
I thought it was called Pimp Juice, because isn't it from the ground?
Oh, yeah, Pimp Juice is the Spike DDT from the ground position. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, never mind. Forget what I said. I want it.
Yeah, that's like the rope for everyone.
Keep the bass vocals.
Oh, also, just to let y'all know, the fucking McRib is back tomorrow.
Yes.
Hell yeah. I'm gonna order one, what, two, what, three, what, four McRibs.
Four? Jesus.
Stone Cold doesn't know when they're gonna be back in stock.
You have four McRibs, you won't have a McRib to begin with.
Oh, hold on, wait for the big fish. Or Shell Shock, I don't know.
Shell Shock, big fish.
Call it whatever you want.
The McFish. Why did they call it the Big Fish instead of the McFish?
No idea. Well, I mean, King. The Big Fish is Burger King.
Yeah.
Wheelbarrow DDT. Oh, hold on, a dropkick to the neck. I got a saver.
There so you can get a wet bun with a fish in it.
This match has actually been pretty competitive so far. Ooh, arm drag. Nice crisp arm drag there. You know, those Atlanteans. Their former technique's pretty good.
I mean, Commando Shark is a champ, so he's going to do something. Good.
Oh, hell yeah. He also had Gorgura sing his theme. He also heard her sing Kiss from a Rose for the last start of the match. Oh, hold on! Power bomb, matchbook pin, 2.9!
I feel like Commander Shark will get a cease and desist soon. He's too big of a shrimp.
Aw, oh, dang, slam him in the face. Bro, you can't do that!
Sure you can, he's a heel.
The hell's wrong with you?
He's not well received, so I mean, he don't care.
Yeah. And you go, Ross. He. Oh, and he goes on. Oh, hell yeah!
Why are you dragging him towards those? What are you doing, guy? Oh my
god. Yeah, that mask is pretty funny. I don't know.
Guys. Thanks.
Gumbuster. Man, you got plenty of good to hit on Aguirre Rossi. Miami! You did this! Is Miami Machine jealous of Commander Shark's success? Is that it? ...85% with the Tiger Lily. That's a weird name for that finish.
I think it's because that's not even... it isn't his finisher. That's just whatever the custom move is. Like I said, I do not care enough to rename every single move in the game.
Right. We only rename the one that we care about.
Yeah, like... The one, like the yoga bomb was just like, that is, no one calls it the yoga bomb, not even the Japanese would call it the yoga bomb.
Call it casket driver, just be done with it.
Yeah, like.
Oh, speaking of new champs, oh, hell yeah, we're about to showcase some new champions tonight.
It took how many fucking months at this rate?
It took after lockdown.
Jesus Christ.
Which I don't really remember when that was, like, when that.
I think that was like the second pay per view, so yeah.
All I know is that a bombshell is gonna be dropped in this match. Everybody stand the hell up. Blood. God, hail to the king of the team. You win one match, and y'all think you own the place, huh? Alright, well, let's see if they can back it up. Because, I mean, you know, unlike the other former champs, I don't think that Stitch and Mortius is going to issue a rematch clause. I think they're pretty much just done with this whole tag team thing. Something just telling you that they're sick of this whole tag team and shit. But yeah, let's see. As Kurt King puts, I believe that's Tommy Thunder in the corner. Ooh, nice knee to the gut.
And Bick.
Sweet.
None of these pieces of trash have killed each other yet.
It's been like 2 minutes.
I've seen a quicker crit.
Yeah, for what was it? Friday?
It wasn't a crit, it was just a 3 minute and, ironically enough, 16 second match.
I died. 316, what? With the pipe drops, raise of hell. R-Drag.
Yeah.
Speed one. Patrick Black and tagged in. Oh, hold on. Oof.
Yeah, there's a bombshell here.
Right. Oh, hold on! And Kurt Key's like, I was gonna say that might cost him the match. Ready? Go! Oh, hold on! Dude, not even a one count!
Yeah, he's kinda doing that Brock Lesnar gimmick.
Right. Apparently.
Hey, he looks like you're back there.
Another time. So say goodbye. Damn, why can't they just let him use that for like WrestleMania at least? Come on, guys. Like y'all have one job. Yeah, one job. They're like, nope, let's just do this instead. I mean, I guess they did it for, like... Didn't they do a version of, Broken Dreams for like one of his like video packages or whatever.
I think so.
Yeah, but like they couldn't do it for WrestleMania. I was like, what the fuck? Come on, guys. Jeff Hardy is like, oh yeah, they get the rights to No More Words. I'm waiting for them to play it. It's like, you know what, Jeff? How much to that? How about you're just a fucking drunk? How about that?
That was a gimmick. Good gimmick? Yeah, okay. Sweet.
How about that for every storyline you're in?
Good gimmick. I think it's 10 out of 10 gimmick, really.
Right.
It took all my creativity.
You know what? You wouldn't have got a screwdriver in your gauge if you weren't a drunk.
Yeah, that was the problem, clearly.
It wasn't that Randy Orton was a sick fuck at the time.
Nah, not at all.
He was a drunk.
Yeah, exactly.
Fucking drunkie.
Yeah. It's all hard to swim. It's a sandwich is for you, dude.
Like a half Oreo sandwich. They make those, right? I feel like I've seen those somewhere.
What, halves?
Yeah, the one where it's like you got the vanilla cookie and then you got like the regular cookie.
I've seen like them sell literally just the filling.
True.
Or like the triple stuff, yeah. Which are just like, yeah, that is way too much at that point.
Nah, I like the triple stuff.
That shit ain't nauseous.
It is me we're talking about, so. Yeah. The only one that made me nauseous was this fucking red velvet one that they came out for Christmas. I was like, this shit, I ate like two of them. I'm like, this shit's fucking disgusting.
Yeah, I remember that one too. Yikes. What about you ever have the confetti one too?
Nah.
That one sucked.
There was like a cookie dough one, I think. That was actually pretty solid.
Don't think I ever had one.
Oh, hell yeah.
Dude,
he's got the dance moves. Bro, him a bishop be at the club. And, bro, they go to Rikishi's club, they feel different.
I mean, if we were WWE, they would have been teamed up already as the Black Bands guys. Cause,
oh, hell yeah.
You know, Vince and his stereotypes.
Just have the bishop just manage him and Rikishi. Oh, hell yeah, I can see it now.
We need a fucking Brother Devon in the group right quick.
Oh, hell yeah.
Oh god, oh. Another one?
God, bro. Tuesday Device is the move of the night.
A one count?
Get that out of here.
No selling shit.
Oh, hell, he's dancing. He's like, oh yeah, I'm feeling different.
This guy's like, a bullshit artist.
Hey, he's the one that got the victory for the team, so. Yeah.
No selling piece of crap.
Right, we should get Kurt Cavers the Blob. Oh no, they're gonna do it again.
Jesus. This guy's gonna have no neck. Yeah, you better run to him.
I gotcha, jump in.
Get that hot tag in.
First L1 and triangle.
I mean, he looks like Drew McIntyre, so his hot tag would literally be run in, do your kick, finish.
Right. Just make sure you press the right buttons for right. Animation, otherwise,
that shit was so overpowered in those games.
True. They had to turn that shit down. Oh, stop him!
Like, order if you pick someone with a running finisher, it's over.
Yep. Edge.
Yep. Edge. I think Jericho was using a codebreaker at the time. It's like when he was beginning. I think Orton actually had a running RKO at one point in that game.
Right. Well, Kurt King just hit a fucking world's strongest slam, so there's that.
Mark Henry in disguise. That's, you know, that's essential chocolate, Mark Henry. There we go.
I got a lot of to the tank. God, why couldn't they give him the fucking title after that, bro? Missed opportunity. Oh, hell yeah. He's like, I ain't fucking done with you. Get the hell out of here. As The Rock would say.
Oh, boy.
Get up.
Oh.
Oh. Huh. Now he's waiting for him. Oh, holy Christ. That's a... Oh, well, that's it. It's over. Look at... Hit hell to the king.
Where's that flip bump kid?
Oh god!
How the? What kind of cell? This guy took a flip bump and gets a.
He's like, here's my bitch. Oh, what the hell?
Kurt King, you wanna?
Kurt.
Yeah, this is Rikishi mixed with Mark Henry. Oh, here he did. Dude dances, dude does the world shark slam, points his stomach. Like, what the?
Hell yeah, you feel different. Oh, what the hell? You gonna hit him while he's dancing? Bro, you made the biggest mistake in life.
Man. Patrick Black had the nice flip bump kick, and this kid couldn't sell for shit.
Oh, sorry about that.
Yeah, hit him with a burning hammer right quick. I know you get that in you. Wait, what are you saying it from me? You got the burning hammer. Shit.
Give me some to break.
Yeah, break his neck right quick. He want to take that flip bump.
Like, alright, kid.
Give him a receipt right quick. Burn hammer. That'll teach you.
I'm gonna do this either way, and I'm gonna have to take liberties.
Hey, Miss Fats with liberties.
Oh, fuck. He's tossing him.
Oh, is he gonna slap for it again? Nope, he's just bringing him all the way over.
Yeah, bring him over to his corner. That's smart. Tactical.
I think he should have set up for it again.
Ah, my stiff blue line. Oh! That's a rope break. Look at him, he's dancing. He's like, oh, hell yeah. Rope break. Rope break.
There he goes, burn. Oh, well. That's about as bad as it could possibly get.
You can still get counted out, so, you know, there's that. Imagine that on the road to Dobbins.
Oh my god. I thought he was gonna stay down. I don't think I've seen someone stay down to a 9 count before on one move.
Yeah, if it was WWE, he would have almost got counted out.
Yeah.
That was like the most dramatic, like, bring back in that you can get. Oh, hold on, with the soccer ball kick. Got him. Got him. He still doesn't go down.
Oh, I thought he was about to kick him out of the ring.
Alright, Patrick Black, you might want to like tag in.
There he goes. See, he knows what he's doing.
Oh, hell yeah. Get.
Oh.
Oh, there we go. Got him. Yeah, you forgot about that, didn't you? What goes up must go down. I'm fighting for my life!
Jeez. Damn, Nick Nitro's having one hell of a night right now.
He's trying to make sure that Kurt King doesn't get any offense. Oh, you know what? I think that might be his downfall right there. Showboating the crowd. See, Kurt King can get away with it. He'll just no-sell you. Has a rope break.
Nick, I was gonna say, don't eat. You're not doing too well in terms of.
Oh god! Yeah, well, now his partner is out of the way.
Oh, there he goes. Nick, that's gonna be a rope break. You're on the wrong side, guy.
And you're also your foot's on the roads. What the hell? Gum Buster.
Oh
damn, World's Strongest Slam.
Kurt King's feeling it now.
Oh hell yeah. Ooh. Dying. Oh, what the hell?
Patrick Black, what in the hell are you doing, guy?
He's gonna kill him. Oh, hell yeah, he's feeling it.
Headshots.
He's feeling it, he's going crazy. Oh, I don't think you want to do this, big man. Oh!
Oh god, oh.
Okay, okay. God. Jokey, jokey, quack, quack. It's good.
Oh, damn. He's gross and everything. Oh, yeah, there's no, the face. Most devastating move in sports entertainment. Oh, yeah, roll up on the illegal guy.
Roundhouse kick. Knock his lights out.
Yeah, but I don't think Patrick Black.
He's not even going for a tag. This is my cost adrenaline rush right here.
I don't know, they're in their own corner. I don't think Kurt King should have hit him as hard.
God, World's Strongest Slam.
Aim the World's Strongest, so let's see, encases the entire ring after he does it.
Is it right?
Oh man, that could have been one of his fucking things. If it's the World's Strongest Slam, have him and Big Show do a fucking go through the ring spot.
Awesome, Timberlake.
Yeah, wait, if I can go through the ring spot or break the ring. Man, if he ever hit the World's Strongest Slam off the top rope, I would've been killer. Mark Henry hits the fucking World's Strongest Slam off the top rope, breaks the entire ring.
Right. Oh god, burning hammer!
Well, he's out of the match for a little bit.
Yeah, his partner is done. Look at his fucking no-seller.
Exactly. At least Nick Nitro's solo to a 9 count.
Right.
This guy was like, no, fuck you.
This dude Tommy Thunder trying to kill Bizzins.
Is the wrestling business dead?
That's what I thought during the Seth Rollins vs. Fiend match.
I think everyone thought that.
Oh, damn.
Hey, look, another person with a complete shot. What do you fucking know?
Oh, damn. Oh, that's a rope break. Yeah, get the hell. Oh, there we go. He was getting into his corner. He was trying to intimidate him.
God damn, dude. This might as well be a main event at this rate.
Right.
Oh, we're here trying to put a 5-star clinic.
Yeah, this is only match 5.
Oh,
oh fuck.
I mean, wrong cornwood. Damn that out of here.
Ah, get him out of here.
Oh, there he is. Now he's in the good core he wants to be in.
Right, mark the throne back.
Oh yeah, roll up. Most devastating move of the Divas there.
Right.
Onto the illegal man.
True. Ah, there you go. He threw him back in. I knew it.
Oh god. Oh, well, that one just fucking career too. While we're on it.
Right. That's it. It's done. Got the 10.
What are you doing, Patrick? Patrick Black, what are you doing? What?
Are we sure these are right guys? No, the tag champs. Oh hell yeah, I know Kurt King is. Oh hell yeah.
There's an imposter among us points at Patrick fucking Black.
Right. Like, what the hell? Like, what's the point of standing guard if you're not gonna, like, do anything? Ooh.
Alright, Earth, no. Count to 10. Let's finish the collision.
I don't know if it's, like, smart or stupid at this point that Nick Nitro is not tagged in Tommy Thunder. He's, like, he's hell-bent to be in this match. No, look at that. You couldn't even get your move off. Kurt King says, I don't give a shit about your move.
He's giving shit about movies, he's giving shit about the finish.
You get no
sympathy for the people.
You get no sympathy for the people. Oh, what? There we go, grab him a little bit. Oh, no pin. Wow! Dialing, he's getting fired up! This is only match 5.
Yeah, pretty much.
Match 5!
Oh, he's fucking necks over here rolling.
He's about to be cringe. Oh, hell yes. You got a hurt neck and he's like, no, it's so drawn. I don't need no tag. This is the reverse Jake Paul whatever match he had. Except it's the black guy beating the shit out of him this time.
Please, something.
Go to sleep.
Are we just made to suffer?
Why are we here? Just to suffer. Oh god! Oh hell yeah, he's beating his tummy. Breaker with the tree trunk like legs. Oh damn, not even a tag. Bro, this team is scoffed.
New team wants to do a damn tag.
Yeah, that Jay White gimmick just throws him around the barricade. Oh yeah, there we go. Oh, Patrick Black. Patrick Black. You standing there does nothing if you can't prevent. You know, it's funny, I told you, yeah, this match card is gonna be like 2 hours at the most.
Yep, and I told you, someone's gonna be like, nah, we're going 8 minutes, bro, don't you fucking worry. Well, lo and behold.
We've gone an hour and 8 minutes.
Yep, lo and behold, it is these two.
Ski-whoa. Tryhards. Oh God.
Stolen. Hey, he's even asking for a tag. Like, dear God, do something.
Stop. I love how both men have just refused to tag out at this point.
Yeah, they put up a five-star quitting.
Turkey with a fucking two taunt spam.
Oh, yeah. Oh, there we go. Get some color in. Oh, my God. What is this match?
This is like the epitome of those online matches. Oh. Oh. At this point, why not?
What in the f- Oh my. You don't pin off that? The guy's practically. Oh my God.
He was trying to crit him. This match is not gonna end until I kill you. Oh God, he's trying to kill him, boy. Duffy's already dead.
Oh,
he's already dead. Oh.
Huh. How about a little less showboat and a little more fucking action?
A little less conversation, a lot more action, please.
What is Jared's fucking line? Less sizzle and more steak or some bullshit.
Buy my sauce, damn it.
No, I'm talking about the SVR line.
Oh, true.
It's something about I'd like to have my steak with a little sizzle, more steak personally, some bullshit. That's fucking Kurt King. Guy just keeps dancing instead of doing some move.
He's like I said, he's trying to murder him.
He ain't murdering nothing.
He's gonna dance on his corpse.
I guess.
He's gonna hit the whip and nene. That one can be whip. That one can be nene. It's gonna be amazing.
Oh God, I'm like, please tag. Come in, back, Patrick Black. Do your flip bump bullshit. Wait, let's bring it home. We get seven more fucking matches.
This has to be a record for the longest tag match on stream.
I mean, if you want to talk long tag matches, me and Noah had to suffer through Faceless versus Supreme for 66 minutes.
Oh, there goes the fish kid.
Yeah, the abdominal stretch. Do one of you idiots have a submission? Let's book this home. Flash submission. Wait, let's get that New Japan bullshit going on. Come on, right quick.
Here, can we get a crit? Can someone die? Look at Patrick Blake, he's gonna do nothing.
He kicked out! The dude missed, he kicked out anyways! Oh my God. Here you go, do your fucking 450 where the hell it is. Oh yeah, the one time you won't do it when he's in your own corner.
You went launching this match? Man, get more dancing. That's what you get. That's what we deserve.
Oh God. Here you go, flippy thing. Flippy. No? Okay, sick. We have seven more matches, you idiots! This isn't Matt Jackson and Nick Jackson every match!
You're not Misawa!
Oh!
Oh, what the?
I've never seen that animation, that's kind of sweet though. Just kick him right up the score. Dude, look at Kurt King, this sweaty bastard over here. Guys, oh, that's a moon.
Imagine this has gone an hour long and it ends via countout.
with him dancing. Yeah. Oh, here we go. Oh, okay. I thought it was gonna be the let's roll around 50 times to get into a ring spot.
The online server special.
There you go, this is finished. No. Throw him into the edge. Oh my god, why? Why would you reset the count?
Because he wants you to suffer.
Kurt King, this isn't the retard ref. He resets the count, buddy.
He's doing the business. Oh, fuck. Double count out, baby. Let's go.
Why? Why would you? Why? You had a count. Are you fucking kidding? You had a count of victory. What?
Oh hell yeah! He's like, he's trying to get him out of his voice. No, one we quit.
Yeah, oh, here we go, though. Let's roll around 50 times, kid. Spin up a little! You know, we put no time limits on. Dear God, do I think we need time limits at times.
60 minutes coming! Yeah, there we go.
Look at all that sweat, dear God. This guy's just shining him up real bright. Holy shit.
Too bad we can't do the 10 count giving. Honestly, I had no idea what to add to this match.
I'm just
losing my mind.
Oh, here you go. Every single Divas finish. And he kicked out anyways. Oh,
holy show. Yes. Oh, he's going down. Oh, he's feeling different.
Alright, here you go. Patrick. Oh my god. Crit him, please. Just alright, burn and hammer him. Yeah, break his neck. He just writhed in pain. Come on, burn and hammer, break his neck. He can be written off television for a month at this point.
So what's the time to beat as far as like longest match?
The longest that me and Noah did was like 66 minutes or some point for a tag team match.
Oh well, we're about to get close to it, baby.
Uh-huh. Although it was Mr. Fats, so it really doesn't count because Mr. Fats. So yeah, we're we're basically 66 minutes with a legit ref.
Oh, no, what do we do? No, what do we do?
Oh, there we go. Yep, he dead. Yep, okay, call the match. Wait, who died? I don't even. Okay, cool, whatever. Yep, sure.
I call bullshit.
Yeah, drop bombshell, he dropped him right in his skull. Good lord, what? There you go. 65 fucking minutes.
I think we can end the car with that.
Yeah, that's the show, here you go.
We gotta go out of time!
Jesus Christ.
Oh man, this is gonna be a hell of a VOD to have.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Yeah, that's true.
We're not trying to die!
Alright, well, hopefully these next
FTR and the Young Bucks took away the rest of your TV time, guys. Better finish every match in 3 minutes or less.
Right, damn. We were supposed to have like match of the year between Bad Omen and Suki Samurais, but fuck that.
Alright, guys, time to finish your match in 3 minutes or else. Figure out how to tell a story, you dweebs.
No, it's gonna be a 60-minute headlong match.
Right.
Oh, hell yeah. So who do you got in this match?
I got the refs at this point.
Yeah. And that's for true. you know what? I'm so burnt out. I can't even make a guess at this point. But maybe I'll get my energy back for match 8. We'll see. We'll see.
I doubt at this rate.
Right.
That last match was too much dancing from Kurt King. The excitement.
Fucking adrenaline rush and royal blood fucking killing me. Ooh, X kick. Ooh.
What?
Got the elbows. One guy's wearing white, one guy's wearing black. I don't know what to tell you. I don't know. Let's see. I guess I could like bring up stats. Stats. Elvacante has 2 points, and Chris Jackson has 2 points. There, those are the stats. Miller's stats is Elvacante has been a fucking loser ever since he debuted. They're trying to break the arm of Chris Jackson. Well, I mean, he is a loser. He lost twice in one pay-per-view.
Yeah, true.
That whole faceless unit is a bunch of losers. They're like the Dark Order. At least the Dark Order is getting some wins under the belt, so yeah, there's that.
Elvacante has been killing it right now.
I can't even remember the last time faceless won a match.
Never.
Yeah. They're retribution at this point.
Yeah, they're just kind of there to be there.
Speaking of retribution, it was nice to see Mia Yim wrestle a match in the main roster. Oh, hold on, STFU.
He's putting that working hole then on.
Yeah, so apparently the mask came off in like 15 seconds. Of the match. Because it's a plastic Tokyo Ghoul mask. What do you think was going to happen?
Oh, it just fell off? I thought, like, that was planned.
No, it was something where, like, Dana Brooke, like, tried to put a hold in. She, like, I think she swiped the mask, and it just came off. And, like, it was not planned at all.
Yikes. Oh, fuck.
Excuse me.
Norton's $15 for a year, Timmy.
My favorite part of that match was after Mia Yim lost and Dana Brooke celebrating on the ramp. Mustafa Ali comes in the ring. He's like, there's no failure in retribution.
Whole team's a failure. What do you mean?
Are you sure about that? Hold on. Let me see if I can play that. Cause I heard that and I fucking laughed my ass off. I'm like, are you sure about that? Oh yeah, fucking match went 5 minutes, 32 seconds. Well, actually, that's probably including the entrances, so it's probably more like 2 minutes. Yeah. Support the troops. Yeah. Shout out to Charlie Cubby. Oh, here we go. Here it is. There's no failure retribution, really. Are you sure about that? There's no failure retribution. All members get beaten up the Fiend. Yeah, that's true. That's for true right there. Oh, buckle bomb.
Well, there went his career.
Yep. Yeah, haven't they pretty much lost all their matches? Oh, there's no failure in retribution. I think the only win they've had was last night when Slapjack won his match. That's literally the only win they've had.
Really?
Yes. Because the other match, wow. Fucking, like, their first match fucking ended in a DQ. And then they straight up lost their second match. The only other match that, like, won was Conqueror League. To Mustafa Ali and fucking Slapjack are the only winners so far.
Well, much like Retribution, good old El Vacanto lost.
Alright, well, two more points for Chris Jackson. He's got 4 points. Alright, let's see. What match are we on now? Now, I'm starting to feel myself. Get back a little bit. Oh, fuck. Speaking of failures.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Stop it to a Slim Jim!
this should be... You know what? I'll fucking... What do I want to... What do I want to do? I will...
Set myself on fire.
I'll do that if Bienvenido gets a fucking roll-up win.
Knowing this game, I would not doubt at this point.
I will set myself on fire.
I don't think we need to have a who you got in this. We know what the hell's gonna happen.
I mean, the only surprise would be what I said.
Yeah, which ain't happened. So, go kill him then.
Yeah, so, Victor Hill has 1 point because of the tie with, Prototype. And Bienvenido has 0 points. Oh, well, that's it. That's the end of the match.
Two! God.
Oh, man. You know what? I don't care what kind of match already it would have been. I would have fucking took that. I'd be like, you know what? 11 second squash match. I'd dig it. Oh, fuck. Oh, man. Who beat? Oh, was it? Yeah, Thoroughly Kaiju was the last person Van Hill faced and he lost.
Oh, Jesus, Phantom already? So again?
At this point, I don't know. Bienvenido, we gotta do something.
Make sure I get his money and go the fuck home right quick.
He's like, man, I'm not spending a lot of time in this match.
So, by the way, don't you love the broken arm gimmick thing happening again, Anor?
Oh, nice. Cool and neat. Oh, yeah, I see it.
Yeah.
Well, you know, trying to powerbomb him like 11 seconds a match. Must have done something to his arm.
Bienvenue, I don't think you're doing too much, okay? Alright, Brent, just powerbomb him through the mat there. He'll be good. He'll walk it off sometime later.
Backbreaker.
And yeah, he's gonna proceed to kill him from here on out for all we're in.
At one point, Van Hill is just like a cat playing with his food.
Like, he could. Vian's getting this shit in, but I mean, like, it ain't doing nothing.
He could end the match whenever he wants, but he's just one of the out. He's torturing him at this point. Just inflicting as much pain as possible. This is for Van Hell, this is just the final nail in the coffin for Faces as far as he's concerned. He already wait, I don't think he's faced Alvacanto yet.
I thought he did. I'm pretty sure he did, because that was like the whole number one contender thing, wasn't it?
Oh yeah, that. But I'm talking about the Proving Grounds tournament.
Oh yeah, no.
So after Bienvenido, he's facing Alvacanto in the at some point.
Oh, here he is, a fish.
Got to 10.
And he did.
Oh yeah, he had to do it twice. He's like, all right, that's it, I'm good. All right, there we go. All right, now I'm hyped up for this match. Vent killing Bienvenidos what got me to get hyped about this match. Now, we are about to find out right here, right now, who's facing Mortal Kombat in the finals next week. Is it going to be Bad Omens, or is it going to be Suki Sunrise?
I'm going to take Suki Sunrise on this.
Yeah. I mean, you know, spoilers. If you saw Sunday's show, you know who I'm going for. I see no reason to change my vote at this point. Why? Yeah. Why is that? There we go, now we can hear Mr. Charm singing in all of his glory. He has a regular ass song for this entrance song.
Yes, because It's a default Makairu, so. I remember I was picking Bab as the default attire.
Well, I mean, that's the attire that she's been wearing this whole period, but I mean, speaking of which, this is actually going to be a match where all these competitors are very familiar with each other. Because Nakamura-san wears his face to be Femme Fatale champion, and Carmella has a long history with this woman right here, Strawberry Suki.
I like a 5-star match in that pay-per-view.
Yeah, I think Strawberry Suki might have actually, like, mixed it up with Mr. Storm at some point. If I'm not mistaken, if not, this is the first time that both her and Nakamura Sunrise have faced Mistress.
Oh, damn.
Here we go. The two best friends going at it right here, right now.
That's one hell of a way to start.
And then Kisa would say, you're my best friend.
Jesus.
Oh, God.
Start up early.
Throw the French shrimp aside. Boom, not factor. That's what this match is. Not even a one count. Strawberry Suki says, you pulled me through hell. You think that's going to end the match for me? That hellacious match we had at, What was the bragging rights pay-per-view we had?
We didn't have the bragging rights one yet. That's crossover. Remember that? That's
all right. I mean, there was one where I did the color scheme where it was like the red.
Oh, you mean Allegiance? With the tag teams? Yeah.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, wasn't that when Carmella and Strawberry Suki had the title match? That was actually one of like Nocturnal's like best title defense matches.
Yeah, I think it was Allegiance.
Yeah. I know I made the match.
Damn.
Oh damn, transitioning. I mean, I feel like there's still a bit of a feeling out process, but Nocturnal just specializing in finding a way to, like, just turn things around and put a submission hold on. That's what makes her dangerous. It's like, you never know when she's going to put on a hold. And, like, if you're not prepared for it, that's the end of the match.
Damn, chops and kicks left and right.
Right. And just, Sunrise just screaming after every chop. I mean, when you scream, you put more oomph into it.
Is that a fact, though?
Alright, I feel like that. I mean, that's what I was taught, at least.
We need to find some scientific proof on that. They need to do a test on that. That'd be cool.
Yeah, comment monsters.
Yeah.
What
are they getting paid government money for? They ain't doing none.
Oh, damn. Those two mixed it up for a little bit, but, Tagian, Strawberry Suki, who probably knows Carmella the best.
Jeez, more strike exchanges. There are a lot of strike exchanges there.
Hell yeah. Going up top. Trust fall. Going for the pin.
Damn.
On the
one count.
Damn. I mean, technically, if one of these women pins Carmella, they're the number one contender for the title.
I mean, there's technicality with everything, because no matter what you are, if you're a champ and you get pinned by someone, you're kind of screwed.
Yeah, that's why right now, Trinity Rush is the number one contender for the tag titles.
Yeah, you might want to make Mistress Charm eat the pin if you're going to lose the match at all.
Right. And like, at that point, she doesn't have to defend the title. Nah, Boston Crab. And now Strawberry Suki attacking the back of her own. Deep cover. Off the ropes. Ooh! That Jay White maneuver. And just smashing her head against the canvas. I mean, Strawberry Suki is also a very vocal competitor as well.
All these, like, loud. They all scream. They're all harlots.
Yeah, they're all like Melina.
I mean, can they do a split though? That's the question.
Wait for it. Alive.
She looks like a horse.
God, that fucking segment ruled. So, what kind of dance move do we do at the club? Oh, that's easy. The fist bump. Yeah! Fuck.
Robbie E was fucking great.
God. The list was amazing. I'm Rob Terry, this is Big Rob. Stab her in the neck with a fork.
No collar though yet.
Nah, not yet. Some people say that Mr. Charm isn't even human.
I mean, you gotta be a bit crazy to wear assless chaps.
I mean, to be fair, I don't think any of these women in this ring are actually, like, you know, human. One of them is a confirmed vampire. One of them might be a vampire just by association. We're not sure what Mistress Charm is, but she hangs out with Daily Reality, who seems to be some sort of dream demon.
Let the darkness consume you.
Oh, damn. And someone's bleeding.
So what do you think, Nocturnal is, then? Is she also a vampire?
She is a complete enigma. I mean, no one really knows anything about her. She seemingly just appeared in out of thin air. She just showed her to Dr. Tuesday. She's like, all right, well, I'm ready to go. I'm ready to do this training program.
Came in wrecking some shit.
There we go. Carmella giving into her vampiric desires. And now, not Nocturnal Sunrise is bleeding.
Yeah, everyone's gonna get some color on this mat now. That's what we need. Liven up a little bit.
I mean, to be fair, Nocturnal Sunrise started out as a Zach's temp. She came in to, like, get trained. She shadowed him. And then she became a competitor. Now here we are.
Yeah, she was getting NXT 2010 trained right quick.
Right? Lift the barrel above your head and run around the ring.
Oh.
You know, I think Titus O'Neil is just cursed when it comes to that kind of stuff. Because he tripped and fell on that one, too.
Oh, yeah, he did. He was making good-ass time, too, before that.
It wasn't just the Saudi where he fell. It was that, too. I remember because, like, Titus O'Neil was trying to, like, join the New Day, and they were like, well, if you can redeem that, you're in. And then, just, like, at the last minute before he crossed the line, he just threw it, like, over his head. Where it was like, no, you didn't do it. You didn't complete it. God, that fucking ruled.
Oh, shit.
Point Carmella. Trying to get one more match with her.
No one will survive.
One. I just want one more match. Christian, you've been whining and complaining, and frankly, you've been coming off like a little bitch. Do you want one more match? I'll give you one more match. But after this, you're done. Christian put in his clause that if Randy Orton gets DQ'd, he loses the title. Yep.
Didn't God, he lose by DQ, though, actually?
He did. Yeah. He did. That fucking ruled because...
Yeah, because Christian's been in the face or some shit, yeah. Right? And then Orton low-blowed
He's been a hot loogie in Orton's face because Booker T was like, oh, God. Oh, my God. And then Orton just, like, fucking kicked him the balls, and yeah, they lost. Dude, that was the Money in the Bank pay-per-view where you had CM Punk versus John Cena. That match fucking ruled. Then it was SummerSlam where Edge came out and Randy just killed him. God. watch that match fucking work. I gotta go back, man. I gotta watch that match again. Okay, baby. Oh, hold on, a double team. Oh, hold on. It's a rope break, though. Yeah, Russell's not even taking it. He's like, that's...
Like, see, we're a woman, so...
He's like, you guys think I'm stupid.
Suki, hun, you're okay.
Oh!
Hey, Suki, taking a lap, yeah?
Wait, she's female Titus O'Neil. Oh, damn, knocking her up, too. She got all that momentum, she came in like a freight train.
Yeah,
like
I guess. Bully. I don't know how the hell she ain't dizzy or exhausted, but sure.
We got to hold on, locked it in. Is she gonna give up? It's for me, so you're gonna get one more match.
Damn, they're going back and forth right now.
20 minutes. Oh, hell yeah, we're getting adrenaline rush and real blood time.
Kill me.
Oh, hold on, wait a minute.
Jeez.
Reincarnation.
Gotta get the cork to break up.
Oh, hold on. Nocturnal Star, she's choking the Femme Fatale champ. Trying to inflict extra damage.
Shouldn't make a tag.
Yeah, probably.
She only ran like 50. There you go.
Hey, here we go. Double team. Oh, no.
Don't even do it successfully.
Hold on, trip up. Oh, wait a minute. Reverse figure four. Is she going to give up?
Suki, you gonna? No? Okay.
She's recovering.
Recovering? Shit, she's right there. She got help.
Okay, baby. Oh, God. She's sent out for Queen of the Damned. Oh!
Suki missed that, though.
Last possible second. Oh, hold on. Maybe a little bit of miscommunication there. Oh!
And throw up on the wrong person.
Carmella's like, yeah, I'm about to finish this. Oh, hold on, trip up.
No, count me.
Oh, hold on. Let the darkness consume
you.
Damn, these women getting some time.
They're doing some AEW shit. Oh, wait.
Nah, we got more than one women's match, so. Yeah, and they put the rest of the women's match on dark. It's like, come on, guys, really? And Kamala Nakam is just trying to inflict more damage at this point.
About to say, who in the hell's a legal woman right now?
Mr. Stern. Oh! This is a big chop to the chest. Okay,
baby. Jeez. Damn, right there, too.
Damn, back-to-back roundhouse kick. A quick jab. That'll soften your opponent up.
She roundhouse, we all roundhouse.
Ooh!
I would count to 20, but she's in the wrong area.
Damn.
She was in the right spot, that was probably gonna be finish.
Oh, hold on, wait a minute, go to sleep, this is how they won! Strawberry.
Hey!
Die! Backbreaker. And, yeah, Mrs. Charm just doesn't know where to put her.
I mean, that's kind of apparent right now, and I'm not too sure why that's the case.
Dropkick in the corner.
Yeah, now she's there in the wrong corner. Oh,
no, hold on.
It might cost her.
Ah. that could have been it right there.
Yeah, it really could have.
Man, Carmella Knockem didn't even slow her down on that one. She was like Michael Myers with that. Akira Sonora is just trying to get her in position at this point.
Another roll up for Carmella.
Let's go! Let's go! But keep in mind, it wasn't Carmella who took the fall. So Carmella knocked him, doesn't have to defend her title against Nocturnal Sunrise.
Carter, did you just, like, say fuck it? Did you think you guys were losing?
Nah, she had a shadow jutsu trap on her.
I guess.
The hands of the underworld grabbed her foot.
Well, you did say none of them were human, so I guess at that rate.
Right. It was like in the movie Evil Dead. Oh man, hell. Oh hell yes. Next week in the finals, Mortal Kombat versus Tsuki Sunrise for the Sinful Sirens Championship. Oh god, it's gonna be a fantastic match. I can't wait for next week. Holy fuck. Next week, I end my semester, and then we do this.
Christ.
Yeah, next week. Yeah, next week is like, that's pretty much
the final. Is that for math or business?
For most of them.
Oh, nice. Damn, then you can full-time stream for yourself, too.
Pretty much, yeah, until eventually my job decides to come back, which I don't know.
Which is never so, yeah.
The movie theater business is dying.
Yeah, I mean...
I might as well just apply at Hot Topic at this point.
I mean, you would fit in.
True. As even if they're open to this one, I don't know.
I mean, I don't feel like malls are doing too well, so...
Yeah.
Because that's more of a mall store to begin with.
Yeah. Like, that's the only thing negative about doing that is I'm gonna have to tell these fucking, like, assholes, like, hey, can you put on your mask? Oh, don't you know what to do? Like, do you wanna, like, be responsible for killing someone or yourself?
Yeah. That'd be fine.
Alright, so who do you got in this one?
I'm taking Mark Spiros.
You know what? I'm going with Mark Spiros too. Let's see. Let's look at the stats. Mark Spiros has 2 points, and so does the motionless one. They're tied.
Nice. It's gonna push the ever so theme. Further.
Fuck your dreams. Fuck your life. We were like talking about fucking dreams, fuck your life.
Yeah, I try to get it to there, and it takes too long.
Yeah. It's fine. I can just sing it. I think you told me about this, but...
Yeah.
The blood's still there from,
Yeah, it has to.
Yeah, from, that's obviously the tag match that we just had. Because I don't remember Kurt King and Patrick Black bleeding. Even though they should have at some point.
65 minutes in, you always thought someone would have blood.
Oh, hell yeah.
Was having an aneurysm the whole time, so there was something bleeding.
We're having elimination style in the favor.
Imagine we had an elimination for that match, elimination style. Oh my fucking...
4 hour pay-per-view, let's go.
Oh boy.
Dang, just a one count.
It's been on Mark Spiros so far.
Yeah, so far. I mean, you know... motionless one agitated Mark Spirals when he refused to shake his hand. He was like, nah, get out of here, shorty. I mean, motionless one's a pretty tall dude.
He's 6'1". Mark Spirals is 5'11". Come on, they're not that big of a part.
Females, 6 foot, Shaq, 5'11", Muggsy right. Bogues.
I love how, what was it, Tinder, I think? I love how Tinder was like, you know, only 25% of the Earth's population is actually 6 feet tall. So based on the analytics we have, a lot of you are lying.
That's true.
I'm pretty much like, look, what you get is what you get.
It's sure, like, if you're 5'11", people just round up to 6 feet because for some reason women see 6 feet, check, 5'11", Muggsy Bogues.
And they're like, ooh, I'm so wet. Sorry, you just... Really? That's what turns you on? Like a big guy being tall?
That 1 inch in height difference goes from them being a superstar to a jobber.
Right. I've been a tier 3 sub for 5 months.
I just really... When Chris motionless pins, he looks like that one Discord mod video guy. And Hitler, but I mean, that's...
Oh, true.
Yeah.
Hey, hello, kitten. I don't think there's anyone here. Oh, there she is. Some poggers. God, I love that video. You know, I was doing this video as a document... Terry in the life of a Discord mod, but this is starting to become more of a investigation, especially after that whole kitten thing. It's a simple question. How old is she? How long has she been on this fucking planet?
Oh my god.
It's a ping. What? It's a ping. I got a solo dispute.
2.9
on the phenomenal forearm.
You know what? He didn't close them. He could have done the phenomenal form into Styles Clash. So that's all.
Remember when AJ Styles? Oh fuck! Remember when AJ Styles faced black tank top Luke Harper? He hit the finisher, but like Luke Harper's foot was on the ropes, and like after the bell rang, he just like very quickly just like knocked his foot off the rope. And then Shane McMahon was like, whoa, hold on, I saw that. We're restarting the match. They had the chance to... They could have made that a fucking triple threat match. Luke Harper versus Bray Wyatt versus Randy Orton, because that was the whole intrigue of that storyline, was the fact that Luke Harper was mean-bugging Orton because he didn't trust him.
Yeah.
It's funny because, like, when Luke Harper, or I guess now he's Mr. Brody Lee, when he was on Jericho's podcast, like, the writers told him, like, the storyline. He's like, you know, like, this is going to make me a babyface, right? And the writer's like, no, it's not. And Luke Harper's like, okay. It's like, all right, whatever you say. Yeah, they absolutely had no plan for him.
Yep, absolutely made a baby face, and they didn't do anything with it.
This dude did a battle royale where he did a Michinoku driver on a dude on the apron. On the apron.
Dude was doing fucking stand, drop, kicks, run all over the place, doing every fucking spot.
Dude,
no.
Dude, 2016 black tank top Luke Harper was over. He was over.
Dude, he even lost weight and everything. Like, he was going crazy.
Dude, like... Oh, God.
He's dead. 1, 2, count the fucking moon.
Like, the baller he was, the stronger he got. And then they changed writers. Road Dogg was booking, and then, alright, no more of this shit. Damn, see how the world stunner. I fucking killed him. Alright, well that's two more for motionless one. That makes him four.
You know, for the tournament people, they're not lucky. They can get a broken neck, broken spine, everything. They still gotta go out there.
Yeah, you only get like a week break at the most.
Kurt King and Patrick Black, well, he got critical, so they're kind of lucky.
True. Oh, here we go.
Yeah, this is gonna be the fucking suplex fest right here.
We got two matches left. We got two spots left. We got a packet of guys. We got five spots left. that was pretty much that fucking royal blood and Adrenaline Rich match.
Right.
Like, we gotta go. We got five spots left. Speaking of which, go check out Gustamine's new album, Anti-Icon. It's actually really fucking good. I dig it a lot. Oh, hell yeah. Fucking Bird Faces theme right here. That's the theme they gave him for the game. Yeah. Whatever his name is. The guy that sings and has that, like, chick manager. Miho Abe. That's the name of the chick. And then you got the Bullet Club chick. Man, I was surprised they never... I'm surprised they never just had like a fun little match between those two. Like, that's it, why not?
Threw him already out.
Kurt King trying to kill him already.
So, by the way, like I was saying, if you see the butt, like it's still there, but like it starts going away, like little bits, it just blends in after a certain point.
Yeah, because you know, it wasn't a fucking murder. There's no vampires in this match.
I mean, there's basically contracted hitmen.
True. I mean, he tried to murder Mar Rivers before the triple threat cage match. And that gauntlet match. Meanwhile, Zach was just sitting in his office, just hanging out with Lucy and Chastity.
Yeah, they were in the bounce house, you know.
Great. And meanwhile, George did a fucking backstage brawl with Corbin Vesper. God, man, just looking back at that, like, at that pay-per-view, and I saw, like, the things that led up to it, I'm like, man, this was amazing. Like, I remember, I wrote that whole promo when I was in the middle of bumfuck nowhere, and I was worried that it wasn't gonna be, I was worried that it wasn't gonna even send, but somehow it got through, and I'm like, yep, there we go, because it was, like, the last day that I was there, I was like, alright, let me just write this in, kind of get everyone kind of prepped for that. I was wild in that day. I mean, I think just seeing that that Braun Strowman and Bray Wyatt match, it made me go insane a little bit. I was like, you know what? Let me just pass on my insanity.
That's when you came in that day. That was like the only match you got to saw because you're in there. It's like, well,
yeah.
Like, you're in and out for most of it, but that's the one you managed to get to see in full, and it's like, hey, what the fuck is this?
Yeah, because then I saw...
Dude got, like, thrown in a crocodile, like, you're some bullshit, like, what?
Yeah. Then the, like, don't you want to fuck me, bro? Yes, I do! Then the water turned red. It's, Friday the 13th ending! Remember that? Remember that movie? Friday the 13th? Jason jumped out of the water.
My.
Oh god!
Joker, what?
Oz is a madman. Kurt King, is that enough? Oh man, I didn't even go over their standings, I think.
Kurt King?
Or Chad Carter, might be. Chad Carter and Oz
Kurt
are
King
both
at
two.
This point has danced his way into the hearts of absolutely no one. He's a fucking indie fetish.
Oh man, I wanna see Kurt King versus Commando Shark.
Yay. We'll be there for 2 hours. Let's put Mr. Fats in too. Let's just really bulk up that time right quick.
Oh hell yeah, Mr. Fats in the elimination style.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Four-man elimination style tag, man. Four men on each team. We'll be there all day.
Oh, Shadow, yikes.
Oh, God. Oh, he's over
here. Spear to the armbar.
Armbar, the most destructive move in sports entertainment.
Right. Now, that's the roll-up. Get it right. Watch the product.
Nah, that's for the females. The roll-up's for them. The armbar's for the guys.
The roll-ups are for the bums that one wink.
Right.
No, I can't wait for Oz to do his little prey gimmick where the crowd just sounds scuffed. Like, what in the world is going on?
Ah, nice. Love Blow Tuesdays.
Yeah, Carmella was keeping it down.
Yep. Adagio was too. That cheap piece of shit.
Running STO. Viva!
Viva La Raza!
Right. I'm so glad that Eddie Guerrero's son is doing well in WWE.
Exactly. I don't know who that Rey Mysterio cat is who's trying to claim him as his son.
Yeah, Uncle Eddie. Get out of here.
Yeah, bullshit. Rey Mysterio's eyes, like, poked out of his head, too. That's what he gets.
Right.
It pops in and out at times on TV.
So apparently, this probably should come to no surprise to you, but apparently, after the whole eye gimmick with Aleister Black, they had no plans for him. They straight up forgot about him, apparently, according to an insider. Like, they forgot that he was even on the roster.
Well, but,
he's on SmackDown. Yeah, he's on SmackDown right now, and he has yet to be here on TV. He asked to go back to NXT, and they straight up denied. They denied his request. They are keeping him hostage.
Wait, just have him and Finn Bálor feud or something. I don't know.
They fired his wife, and they won't let him go back to NXT.
Wait, who the hell is his wife?
Zelina Vega.
Oh well. Selena Vega, who also, managed Andrade Cien Almas forever, so that.
Right. Yeah, and then you got someone's hot takes like, oh, they fired Selena Vega for Twitch. Why didn't they fire Paige? It's like, alright, first of all, Paige isn't medically cleared to be in the ring. So at this point, all they do is just use her for social media stuff.
Yeah, and like, secondly, if they fire Paige, it's like, it's whatever at that point. Yeah. Like, they're just being stupid.
Secondly, Paige changed her Twitch name. And thirdly, Paige is way more up in the card than Zelina Vega. They pretty much use Zelina Vega as an example. Like, they made an example out of her. They're like, alright, yeah, she's low enough in the card where, sure, it'll maybe stir up a little bit, but I mean, it's dropping the bucket at this point. It's not like a Randy Orton or a John Cena or something like that where, you know, we're actually gonna lose like a whole lot of people for this. Come on, get a clue. Live in the real world. Nah, my own little world. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. I'm just gonna play that whenever someone has a really stupid hot take. Like that, like that
tweet. Clown College music. What do you mean?
Like that tweet I saw today before we went live, where it's like, "What are you talking about, bro? Hybrid 3 Reimagined had the better remixes of the songs.
What did I just see?
I don't know. Well, whatever it was, Chad Carter won.
Well, that's a custom move that the person who made Oz put on him, so yeah, that'll get scrapped.
Right.
Your move doesn't work.
Like, oh yeah, Reimagine has like the better remixes, and their stuff after Meteora was actually way better. It's like, are you fucking kidding me? Hold on now. I'm not misquoting this. Y'all have to hear this stupidity. Verbatim. So, to John Blood, he posted the video clip of them talking about the best songs from Hybrid Theory. And I wrote, honestly, Hybrid Theory and Meteora are their two best albums. I wrote that 6 hours ago. And then someone replied to me at 7:13 p.m., nope, Reanimation had basically much better versions of the original songs, and the work after Meteora improved a lot. Improved a lot?
Sure.
Improved a lot?
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe in the pop area, but not the sound that they started off with. Honestly, like, the only... Hold on. I can go on my... Yeah, hold on. See, I got L right here. The only other album I have after Hybrid Theory and Meteora is I only got, like, 2 songs off Minutes to Midnight. And it's Bleed It Out and What I've Done. And that's it. That's Lillian. So you know what? You go now. Oh, hell yeah. The A-Block main event of this week. You know what? I'm surprised, you know, who didn't show up tonight being like, man, am I on the card? Because, He's got a very important match next week. That's actually going to be, like, I'm going to rearrange it where that match is the main event of that week.
Might as well. I mean, shit's the biggest implications in that block.
I mean, pretty much the winner of that match becomes the A-block leader. If you guys have been paying attention to the points, you know what I'm talking about. Oh, hell yes! Yeah, the Punjabi Playboy, baby! Zach the Vampire will be doing his stream at some point tonight. I was gonna say 10, but it's 9:57, so after that.
Hey, maybe 10:30. Who knows?
10:30, 11.
All right, guys, you get 3 minutes to finish your matches. Let's go.
Right. Keep in the back. Ooh. Pele kick. Nice. See, Prince Shu is very dangerous when it comes to footwork. Let's see, what are these guys' standings? Prince Shu has 2 points, and Griffin has 2 points, so yeah.
Is there anybody in the block with 0 points now? Besides Dante Lin?
Me Bowers, oh, Emo yeah. Boy, Dante Lin.
Damn. Two of those names, you know, those are big time guys.
Yeah, one of them. I'm very surprised about. Well, you know what? You got, what? 7 more matches?
Nah, they got. We've only done,
I feel like I've only done, like, 2 nights so far.
Yeah, like. Who has the most points? Isn't it 6?
Yeah, 6.
Yeah, so we've only done 3 matches.
Well, I mean, those two had an extra match.
Yeah, so that's what I mean. We've only done 3 matches for some people, so they got right. Like at least 16.
Right.
I mean, not 16, fucking 14.
So Prince Shu, for example, this is like his third match.
Yeah, so he's got 13 after this.
Yeah.
So yeah, this is a long way.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, Emo Boy could definitely turn it around at this point. He's still got time.
He's only fought in two matches, right? Or is this going to be his fourth?
This might be his fourth. Because he was on the pay-per-view.
Oh, well, he definitely needs this one. You lose a quarter of your matches, you start to fade away a little.
If I go with the, if I go with the match that I'm planning on, then if he doesn't win, I don't know what to tell him. Because his challenge, his opponents are only going to get tougher at that point. I don't know, maybe he's like, you know what? Screw these easy matches, bro. I want to go all out for like the harder matches.
I mean, it's a marathon, not a sprint, so you can conserve yourself.
Right. I mean, hell, think about it this way. Jay White lost 4 straight matches in his G1 and still ended up in the finals like last year.
Yeah, so anything can happen.
It's possible. Oh, hold on, what Lighten. The?
Jesus.
Oh, holy.
Pin him, please.
Hey, I mean, it's apropos that he's got a white attire because he moved like lightning on that one. Dragon Screw attacking the long limbs of Prince Shu. It's hilarious because Prince Shu's first opponent in this tournament was Zack Roper. Now, a lot of people actually considered Prince Shu losing to Zack to be a bit of a surprise or an upset, you could say.
I mean, it was a 6-minute squash, it felt like.
Yeah, Zack pretty much put the final nail in their rivalry. He's like, alright, I'm done with you. I'm more focused on guys like Mar Rivers. Speaking of which, Rivalry of the Year would be a really... Oh, hold on, what the hell?
This guy's pulling out every damn...
Oh, hold on. One more angel! No!
He is moving, I will give him that Griffin is
showcasing. Garoshi. Hell yeah, that's what this tournament does. This is the showcaser right here. Oh, what the face plant DDT. No. These guys said we want time. We got 5 spots. We got 5 more spots. Oh, hold on, jumping DDT. Oh, hold on, Prince, you're going to the top. No.
Oh, near he's the in the wrong
back of the
spot.
Head. Near the back of the head. The biggest oopsie. No recovery. And he suplexes. Oh, God. I don't think we've seen this before. Jesus. Oh, God.
Prince Shu's getting primal now.
He says, I'm feeling different. Oh, Griffin's gonna try to have him count it out. That's a smart strategy.
That didn't happen, though.
No, I didn't do enough damage. Oh, hold on, turn it around. Oh! Spin kick to the back of the head. You know, the shots that hurt the most are the ones that you don't see coming.
Jeez, he gets him again.
Yeah, knee to the head. That's it.
Oh, that CT special kid.
Oh, hell yeah. Ooh. Prince Shu turning around, man. He's turning his whole thing around. He's at 4 points.
Yeah, he's shiny now.
Oh, hey kid, want to see a dead body?
Hey, look, this song replayed twice, so you know.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, you know, speaking of main eventers. Yeah, well, welcome to the main event spot, kid. And don't you complain, because Zack Roper had 2 matches in one night. He lost he was screwed out of his handicap match, and then lost his second match of the night. So I don't want to hear it. Agia Rossi's riding that high after beating Commando Shark. Now let's see how he actually performs in this tournament match. Because that's where this counts. You know, exhibition match. All right, whoopee, good for you. You bullied Gorgor's biggest fan.
Does he have 4 points right now?
Let's see. Agia Rossi's got 4 points, yes.
Nice. He's still in good.
He beat,
So is he 2-0 right now?
Yeah, 2-0. Yeah, you want to talk about upsets. Oh, well, you know what? This might be the biggest roadblock in Agia Rossi's block. Because right now, Kaiju is just... he's running away with it. Right now, the people with the most points are him and Gen Hunter. He also got Ferguson Gray next week, too, so... he's got 4 points. But right now, Gen Hunter's got 6 points in the B block. Kaiju's got 4. Agia Rossi's got 4. Check Hard just got 4. And Ferguson Gray's got 4. So they're all kind of jockeying for position right now.
Their book has a lot of 4s.
Yeah. Well, I mean, there's a couple 4s in A block too.
Yeah.
Yeah, this after the end of
Do
night.
Do they have any zeros?
Who? B block?
Yeah.
Psycho Keanu.
That's it?
Bienvenido.
Okay, well, if Bien does count, he sucks. That's to be expected.
Yeah, put Bien, them together next night. Suck. Gonna put them together next night.
One of them's gonna get a point, right?
What if I just, like, what if they just continue getting zeros and I just save them for the last night?
Right.
One of these losers is gonna win.
Ends up being a fucking draw.
They both end with 1 point.
Imagine they both just walk out. One. No contest.
One. Right. Two. I mean, either way, a draw is gonna be 1 point each, so. Four. Five. Six. Hold on, at this point, seven. Kaiju's just punishing Agia Rossi. He's like, yeah, I saw that match. That was fucked up, dude. I don't think it's a good idea to just taunt right in front of Kaiju like that.
Hey, Kaiju, right, let him taunt.
We've seen Kaiju when he's gotten riled up. And that's not a good thing. Neither the gut. Yeah, if Agia Rossi loses, he's gonna be like, oh, I already had a match tonight. Yo, Skull Dog GM throwing their weight around. It's like it's a 16-man tournament. You
call a person on one of the nights to compete, you moron.
Right. It's like if it wasn't gonna be this week, it'd be next week.
Although, who knows? Maybe it was a warm-up for him. It was the third match. He's had 9 matches to rest up. I mean, technically,
right.
Kurt
King
and Patrick Black won over an hour, so he's had some time to rest.
Yeah, that match gave him plenty of time to recover, so I don't want to hear any excuses. Bring it. Bring hold on, strike on, Fez. Bring it. See, this is where Kaiju tests his opponents. Bring it.
Bring it. Damn, long exchange there. Throws him out.
Just throwing him out of the ring.
Throw him out like the piece of trash he is.
Ooh! Sliding elbow. Or forearm, whatever you want to call it. But wait a minute, Agia Rossi. Fight back. Going after the legs, that actually might be a smart strategy.
It would be, except for the fact that I don't think we've seen Adagio do anything more about Boston Crab than his little submission repertoire.
He's just gonna make it his mission to make him tap out. Just like when just like when Jay White had that like tag team against Okada and Naito. Or no, Okada and who was the champ at the time? Tanahashi. And he was like, I'm gonna make Tanahashi tap out tonight. I don't care what happens. And that was when he like got the when he did the TTO for the first time. That match ruled.
Come on, do a flippy thing. Damn.
It's funny that Jay White has only like done the TTO like oh damn. He's only been able to successfully like get a tap out from the TTO like for two matches. Yeah. He did it against he made Tanahashi tap out and he made Juice Robinson tap out. In that same tournament where he was like 0-4 until he got to the finals.
Oh, there he goes attacking the leg, which, you know, he doesn't really do anything to the leg besides that.
Right.
You know, we didn't call Odoji Orochi the brightest of bulbs, but hey, they do.
Right.
He's gotten some lucky wins. Sheesh, Hushi Kuroshi, those are good add up.
Right. Is that my imagination? Are these guys like the same height?
I think so.
Cause I know Kaiju's like not really like the tallest dude. Yeah, I gotta do some research after this stream. Stamina, stamina.
Blackstone.
Mom likes no.
Can you say it to Wumbo?
Triple B, bring back Booker.
That's what we need. Get Byron Sexton out of there.
Oh, hold on. I thought he was going for a burning hammer.
Nah, that was a spicy drop.
Oh, what the? Oh, with the fever on the dance floor. Six. And you're out to get this point.
Six.
He's got 6 points. At this point, if he beats John Hunter, he might be the sleeper winner of this block.
I don't know, isn't Ben Hill and Prototype and Dealer in that blog too, though?
True. Like, Mommy, just...
That's a big boy blog, so who knows, they can come around at any time.
True. Like, hey, I'm on top of the world, and then all of a sudden he just crashes down.
Right.
That'd be hilarious. Oh, man, what a show. We had ups, we had downs. We had Kurt King just dancing over corpses that backfired on him. We had the amazing women's tag match between Bad Omens and Tsuki Sunrise. That's one of the highlights for me, honestly. But we will see you guys next week. Next week we're gonna have the finals when Mortal Kombat takes on Tsuki Sunrise, and then we're gonna have the rest of night 3 for Proving Grounds. So yeah, this should be an interesting show next week. We're gonna have to change the format a little bit.
Yeah, just a tad bit.
Just a tad bit. Just a tad bit. Yeah, a little bit. But yeah, we gotta go out of time.